kiss.
What is so important that you leave everything open?
I just wanted to help out a bit, like you keep telling me to. I wanted to feed the cat.
You wanted to feed the cat?
Yes. Where is he?
The cat's dead, Les. A long time ago now.
No. Are you sure?
Coming.
You lost something?
I'm just looking for the latest vaccination guidelines. Thank you. Oh no, wait, these are last year's. I want this year's. Thank you.
And this is your elbow, and that's
your... Very funny, thank you. Ha-ha.
Sounds like it was just the job. Nick was telling me about the retreat he went on at the weekend.
Oh, yes.
Yeah, it was helpful, definitely. I mean, some of it's just common sense, and a lot of it I knew already, but just spending some time thinking about things, opening up to new ideas.
Well, that can only be a good thing.
You're not going to be dangling crystals from the ceiling, I hope.
Don't worry, I'm not too far gone. Mind you, there was a fascinating session on the colours that we surround ourselves with and how they can promote positive energy. See? Now, that negative attitude probably comes from the fact you're wearing too much brown today.
Yes, I can definitely feel a lack of positive energy about you.
Purple. You should wear more purple.
You're both being rather childish. I've got work to do.
Seriously, though, I'm glad it went well.
Thanks.
Well, I'd better be off. And remember what I said about carrying for you. Just say the word.
George!
Listen, I'd love to hear all about it, but I'm late, you know. I'll catch you later.
Yeah, sure.
Some patches of dryness. In the heavier bursts, there is the potential to get up.
Another one!
What's that?
There was a woman reading the news, then there was a woman telling us about the weather, and now there's this woman telling us how to decorate the house.
Les, I'm going out to the doctor's. I've written it on the board. Put the chops in the oven at 12 o'clock. All right. The ones you liked last week.
They're everywhere. Now, this property
at the moment is... Well, there's no reason you can't have a woman present a television programme, is there?
Well, I mean, I'm all for a bit of equality, but as far as I'm concerned, they are taking us over. There's even a woman now telling the builder what to do.
12 o'clock. Chops in the oven. All right.
Where are you going?
To the doctor's.
Well, all right. No need to get shirty. Ah, Another one, eh?
Hey, your next patient's ready, and Vivian knows you've got nobody in here.
Sorry, I was just looking at some of these.
What are they?
Oh, nothing, just doing some reading.
You okay?
Yeah, yeah, fine, just a bit tired. That's all. Mr. Gresham, sorry to keep you waiting. This way, please.
As I was saying, you really are very early. Your appointment's not for another 45 minutes, and Dr. West is running late this morning.
I don't mind waiting. You've got some nice magazines. I could just sit here and read them.
Thanks.
Mrs. Turner, I'm seeing you a bit later, aren't I?
Hello, Doctor.
I was just saying that Mrs. Turner really is very early.
You could come back in a while if you'd like.
Oh, no, I'm very happy staying here, reading magazines.
Sure. I'll see you later. Mr. Davis.
Dr. Woodson left these yesterday. I just haven't had time to put them out yet.
Oh, how lovely. Thank you ever so much.
Mrs. Turner. Would you like to follow me?
Okay. There you go. It's too much reading in bed. That's the problem.
How did you get on with the respite care arrangements?
Oh, yes, they did come and do an assessment, the council workers. Very nice she was, the lady, but they seemed to think we were doing all right.
Did you answer all the questions truthfully?
Oh, yes, of course.
Well, it's surprisingly a common problem. We see a lot of people that need and deserve the help, and then someone from the council comes round. Well, it can be hard to admit to a stranger that you're not coping as well as you'd like.
Well, I'm coping fine. I mean, he is a bit difficult sometimes, but, you know, he means well.
What about family, friends? Could they not look after Les, even if it was for a day or two?
Well, my son's very busy with his career. Our friends are kind, but it's a lot to ask somebody, isn't it? Look, it's a... great to see you looking so well, Dr. West. It really is.
Right, you and me were off out at lunchtime.
What?
For sure, that's what you need. Well, that or a kick at the backside, I'm not sure which yet.
I'm fine.
So I'll come and get you in an hour, okay?
What about all your appointments?
Hello, some of us are efficient and organised. I know I've seen your list, you haven't got anybody in until this afternoon.
Nah, I don't fancy it.
That wasn't a request, sunshine, it was an order. Remember, I outrank you.
We're not in the army.
Archie, no arguments. Go on, if you're good, I'll even treat you to an ice cream.
What you need, some early nights, some rest. But I'm gonna prescribe some eye drops just to help things along a bit.
Oh, thank you, Doctor. Oh, yes. An early night, that would be nice.
Not always easy.
Well, Les, one of the side effects from the brain damage is that he just doesn't need much sleep. I mean, is that normal, Doctor?
When it comes to the brain, any combination of symptoms and side effects is possible. Is his short-term memory no better?
No, it's terrible. Oh, it's been 2 years, Dr. West. Is he ever going to get better or not?
Well, that's difficult to say. It's possible, but I think you're going to have to reconcile yourself to the idea that it won't. But keep plugging away at the same things, you know. Talk to him about places he's been, things you've done together. Just keep him busy. Get him to meet people and talk.
I mean, could I bring him in to see you? He liked you. Even for a few minutes. I mean, you could see what you thought of him. Maybe you could see if he's getting better or not. This afternoon, maybe.
Okay. I suppose I can get someone to cover for me after lunch.
Well, 2 o'clock, then.
Okay, 2 o'clock.
Thank you.
Oh, you idiot! Watch where you're going! This is supposed to be for pedestrians! Arch? Archie, are you okay? Come on, why don't we sit down? So?
Do you know what epiglottitis is?
Inflammation around the entrance to a larynx. Why?
I've got a nice treat for us this afternoon, Les. We're going to go and see Dr. West.
Oh. Nothing to do with me.
Oh, of course it's to do with you. Who else would it be to do with?
What's for dinner?
Shots! Put them in the oven at 12 o'clock. Remember, I wrote it on the board.
Well, they won't cook in time now, will they?
No, they won't. Oh, why don't you try harder? I try so hard every day and you just sit there so useless, so thoughtless. Why don't you just try?
Is it your time of the month or something?
Oh, you stupid man. Why are you so stupid? I'm 59. I'm 59 and this is my life. This is my life stuck here with you.
What's all that newspaper doing on the floor, eh? Somebody could slip on that, you know. So, what were we having for lunch?
He just couldn't breathe. And Stella was screaming at me to help him, and I knew I could have done something. There was a little hole. I know the theory, I could have done it.
You're not trained to do that kind of procedure, and if it had gone wrong, you would have been struck off.
He was dying in front of me. And the irony is, I was too scared to help in case I killed him.
It's not your fault.
Maybe I'm not cut out for this job.
Come on, of course you are.
He was my age, a wife and a kid. He deserved more than to die on that grubby pathway.
Archie, sometimes there's nothing you can do, and that's really hard to accept. I mean, take my dad, for instance. Even now, I wonder if I could have done something more.
Yeah, maybe.
No, not maybe. That's just how it is. And it's the hardest part of what we do.
Oh, I'm glad to hear that, Fran. So this weekend, will he bring his girlfriend?
So, was the retreat good?
It was illuminating.
I sense a butt coming.
I think I expected a bit more from it, you know. It was helpful and there's lots of interesting people, but I don't know, I suppose I probably was looking for some, well, shortcuts.
I don't think there are any. Still, if it helped open your eyes to something new, then that's got to help.
Yeah, I know.
Mental battle is as important as the physical one.
Well, maybe.
Well, hello again.
This is my husband, Les. Dr. West said he'd see us this afternoon.
Yes, he did mention it. Take a seat. He'll be free in 10 minutes.
You're not a doctor, then?
No, I'm the receptionist.
Oh. You like it?
Well, yes. Most of the time.
Good for you. You're in a minority these days, you know.
Les, just leave it.
I'm not sure I follow.
What's good about women like you is you know your place and you don't get ideas above your station.
Oh, yes, please.
But, I mean, it's just common sense. Men are the ones designed to be in charge, who do all the hard work, all this business about women wanting to do everything. It's just unnatural. Tell me I'm wrong.
Why don't you take a seat, Mr. Turner? It's very nice to meet you.
I've just got to go to the car. I'm not sure that I've locked it.
Go on, then.
Hello? You can't come at all. Did he say when he'd be able to come? Yes, I see, of course. I quite understand. Well, perhaps you could ask Jason to call me when he comes into the office. Tomorrow, then. Goodbye, dear.
Right, Dr. West, I'll send them through. Oh, I just need to find where Mrs. Turner is.
You say her car's gone?
I don't know what she drives, but there's no sign of her anywhere.
Maybe she's just...
I get the impression she's under a lot of strain.
Well, she is. Her husband developed viral encephalitis a few years ago and went into a coma and suffered brain damage. And there have been some other behavioural side effects.
I noticed he was a bit of a straight talker.
Maybe she's just gone off for a bit of shopping while he sees me.
Yes, maybe, but... This morning she took a magazine. It was a travel magazine, and she took it rather furtively. I don't know, it probably doesn't mean anything, but...
Maybe. Show him through anyway.
Mr. Turner for you, Dr. West.
Mr. Turner, how are you?
You're a cripple.
Yes, I'm in a wheelchair. Take a seat. Did Jean have breakfast with you?
Yes.
What'd you talk about?
The election, of course.
The election?
That woman, Mrs. Thatcher, can you believe it?
Yes, really something.
Well, it's bad news for the like of us, Doc. They're trying to get rid of us, you know.
Who is?
Women. They don't like us. Even her. My own wife. I catch her staring at me sometimes.
Really?
I'm just an old-fashioned sort of chap, Doc. For better or worse, I don't say anything, and I'll stick by her. But sometimes I feel I might be better off on my own.
Do you know where Jean is now?
Oh, she'll be at home, doing the washing or something.
It's just, she came in with you earlier, didn't she?
Do you remember?
No, I came on my own. I mean, why would she want to come with me anyway?
My mistake. I tell you what. Why don't I take you home and we'll go and see how Jean is. Make sure she's okay, yeah?
I'm gonna sit on your lap, am I? Come on, then. Stirling Moss. Oh, there you are. Have we got any cake? I want some cake.
You okay?
Yes, of course. Fine. I was I was just coming to get him. Sometimes you have these little panics. I suddenly thought I'd left the gas on, so I had to come back and check it. I knew he'd be okay because you're all such nice people, and it was just for a few minutes.
You've been gone for over an hour, Jean. Surgery's only a few minutes away.
Well, yes, but what are you trying to say, Doctor? I had to come back to check the gas. I didn't want the whole street to be blown to kingdom come. I had to come back to check the gas.
Jean, it's okay. It's okay.
Oh, you've got so many people to help you. I don't have anybody.
It's your answer.
He's watched that DVD about 100 times, maybe more, and every time it's as if he's watching it for the first time. Must be nice, in a way, to be like that. It's the opposite for me. I get to do the same things over and over again every day, and each time it's just a little bit worse, a little bit more difficult. He's not getting any better, is he?
No, I don't think he is. But
you're not a specialist, I know, but we both know that.
I know you're not getting the help that you need. I'm going to do something about it.
Ooh, I never thought he'd get that one.
I would have come back, you know. I wasn't going for very long. I wasn't going very far away. I just thought if I could have one night away in a little hotel somewhere, it could recharge my batteries a bit.
If we get the respite care from the council, you'll be able to take regular breaks, which will make a huge difference. When I get back, I'm going to call them, and they're going to send someone round to talk to you again, okay? But this time, be honest. Tell them that you're finding it difficult.
Shall I tell them I was going to run away? Will that help? Look, I can see bits of the man I married, glimpses of him. But it's all mixed up with somebody else, somebody I don't like, and I have to look after that person, and I don't even know who he is. Well, that's not fair, is it?
Just tell the truth.
What? Even that he wants to come into my room every night like some sex-crazed teenager? You want me to tell them that? Well, even my son won't come here anymore. I can't even get him on the phone. Just his snotty secretary who can't wait to get rid of me.
Jean, I'm going to help you. You're not on your own. I just need you to hang in for a few more days. Can you do that for me? I'm going to get you more help.
You promise?
Cross my heart.
I'm sure you've got other things to do.
Yeah. I'll call you tomorrow and tell you what's happening. Les? Les? I'm off now. See you soon.
Okay. Cheerio, then. I inside.
It's all right.
I'll tell you something, Doc. Seeing a nice chap like you in a wheelchair makes you count your blessings, doesn't it, love? Yes, which Norwegian town hosted the 1994 Winter Olympics? What name from a Malay word meaning roller is given to the 7 species of scaly anteater found in tropical Asia and Africa? Angela? Yes, which talent?
I'm sorry if I've been a nuisance.
You're not.
I'm not going anywhere.
I'll call you in the morning. You're not on your own.
Jean! You there?
Yes, I'm here. I'm just coming.
Dr. West, did you get everything sorted out?
Yeah, she was just at home. Is Georgian?
No, she had to dash out, a house call.
Listen, thanks for your help today.
You're welcome, Dr. West.
Listen, I've been thinking. Why don't you go and talk to one of the doctors about what happened?
What good would that do?
Well, I think you need to hear from one of them that you didn't do anything wrong. Someone like Joe, he's a really good listener.
Yeah, I know.
So you'll go talk to him then? Why not?
Because he'll tell me I did nothing wrong. I know that.
So what's the problem?
The problem is there's a difference between not doing anything wrong and doing everything you can.
Archie, we've been over this. We're not trained to do that kind of procedure.
Yeah, but I could have tried. Like, one thing that I've always enjoyed about doing this job, if I'm honest, is sometimes people look at you as, you know, a little bit special. You're someone to turn to when there's a problem. And now I know that at the end of the day, I'm not anything special.
Archie.
What would you have done if it was you there with him dying in front of you? You'd have done the tracheotomy, wouldn't you?
I don't know.
Yeah, you'd do. You'd have done it, wouldn't you? Wouldn't you?
George, Danny Dice.
Hiya.
Or should I say Chris Kringle?
Tell me what.
It's what I care about is that the Ronnie Woodson that I married would have been defending him against an unwarranted intrusion into his privacy.
This Ronnie Woodson's got to support a family.
I suppose you're disappointed I didn't break my neck. I would say the expense of a divorce.
Divorce?
I saw you with another man in his bedroom.
Another round of Junior Mastermind tonight at 7:30. Stay with us now on BBC One for Neighbours.